Another reason I think we are doomed is that we are not paranoid enough. And I worked with a lady who once said to me, never trust anyone with a project if they're not paranoid about what can go wrong. I so agree, I am a control freak. I have my own t-shirt that says, yes, I am a control freak, but only when I don't know who is in control and I immediately have to take over. We're not paranoid enough. Here are some photos I have taken with my mobile phone. You walk into a restaurant and they have this bowl and it says, win a free dinner, place your business card here. The biggest rising theft is identity theft. All you need is 5 items of information and I can pretend to be you and have a credit card delivered to me. And on it goes. So I would never put a business card in there like this. Anyone can just pick it up. And now they know your name, your extension, and then I'll just steal something from your rubbish bin. And I was on a flight from Sydney to Hamilton Island, and there's only one aeroplane that flies there now, so I had to sit in this aeroplane, and they don't have movies or anything. You can pay $5 and get a DVD player. It was holiday season. I was there for a conference. I sat in the back seat. There were hundreds of people. And I could see they started serving. An hour later, they got to me. And she said, what would you like? I said, I'll have a DVD player, please. First time ever. No, I've never done this before. And she said, that'll be $5. I said, fine. And then she said, can I see some ID? And I thought, do I look under 18 to you? What have you got on this that I need to be an adult for? She said, no. It's just that people have been walking off with them. I said, at 30,000 feet? I'm the only one who's asked for one. What do you need? She said, I need your driver's license. Now, being who I am and the security freak that I am, my driver's license, everything's on my driver's license. You have a specimen of my signature, you have a photo, you have my date of birth, you have my home address, you have a driver's license number. End of story. End of ID. So I wrote a letter to the managing director of the airline. I said, look, I must alert you to this. We cannot train a society to hand over ID like this. And he wrote back a hideous response. They said, oh, you know, it's just that we implemented the system and then we were losing something. He just didn't get it. He didn't get it, what I was trying to say to him. Non compos mentis, did not understand. And banks to this day, and credit card companies to this day, and only last week one of the largest banks called me and said, hello, Mr. Nader, can I have your password so I can talk to you? Have you heard that? And I tell them, I say, you must cease that practice. You cannot train people that it's okay for someone to call you and say, I'm from your credit card, can you please give me your password? I have something to tell you. It is I just can't believe it's still going on. And I wrote a letter to the head of that big credit card international company, non compos mentis. I just cannot believe it. I'm sitting here screaming, thinking, I could tell you stories all day long. And it's just so amazing that we are not paranoid enough about what can go on. The other reason that I think we fail in organisations, let alone terrorism, is that there's this them and us situation. There's a bank near me where this ATM thing has been chock-a-block for 18 months. I just cannot believe it. I walk past it every single day, and I think someone somewhere, somehow, will say this is full. Now, not that I care that it's full. I really don't care that it's full. I care that 20 people can work at this bank and walk past it, and there's, oh, no, I'm just the teller. I'm just the controller. No, I'm just the chief bank manager elevating the organization to make people look and think. So I wrote a letter to this bank, because I love playing games, and I said to them, in a fake name and everything, I said to them, I'm an insurance expert, which I'm not. I really don't know if this is true or not, but I wrote a letter. I said, I'm an insurance expert, and if a customer puts a cigarette in there and your bank catches fire, ipso facto, you're responsible. And you might not be covered under insurance. The very next day, they put danger, danger, stay away, and they put witches' hats and they pointed everywhere. And within 3 days, they removed the thing altogether. We just don't get it. I walk past cameras wherever I look at cameras. I'm the most suspicious person anywhere because I'm always looking. This cord was within anybody's reach. You could just walk past it and pull it. I thought, what's the point in that? I saw this just in a building opposite my building. I said, anyone can just grab this. They said, oh, yeah, thank you. So they fixed it. Look how they fixed it. They tucked it in a little bit. My mother, bless her soul, she had so many problems medically. So she was at a hospital, a major good hospital, brilliant hospital. And I walk around, she was there for weeks and weeks, and you know, I'm caring for her and I've got nothing to do, so I just walk around, do an audit. And I saw these cameras everywhere. And I thought, why do we bother? I looked at these cameras and I thought, I know what's going to happen. And sure enough, not that I'm a clairvoyant, but within a matter of 2 weeks, gone, stolen, taken. It was obvious to me, and I'd only been there 2 weeks. I can't believe it. That one is in a lift. You know how short, how narrow or how lifts, you just turn it off. Well, I can't understand it. Either to commit a crime or to take the camera home, because it's useful, you can use the camera. Why do we bother? So I've been telling people for years, you cannot do that. So they've listened, this is a casino. So they've put it in a metal casing. I said, fantastic. But behind the metal casing, you needed a pair of nose pliers, snip, gone. And not only that, they didn't inspect what they were doing. Do you see the number there? This is camera number 338, sector T1. I sometimes wonder how, in Mission Impossible, what's his name, Tom Cruise, knows everything within seconds and they map it out and crap. And I think, oh, that's so unreal. Not here. I can map out the entire casino grid for you. I've left all the markings on in every car park. We just fill the order. Well, this is a marina and we've got to protect it. Okay. Foot on block, foot on here, foot on fence, around foot on cabinet, over the doodah, kill the cameras, there's you've got the yachts of the world for you. I mean, what's the point? A friend of mine drives this yellow, no longer, he's changed it, but he had a yellow Porsche. Mont Blanc this, Cartier that, Prada this, Boss that. He's a real target for anyone looking for someone to mug. His building was sick and tired of people parking in the wrong place, so they said, this is it. If you don't have a sticker on your car will be towed away. So now my friend walks around the city, drives around the city, telling every would-be anybody, I am in apartment 611, I park in C3, bay 611 in the blue concept building, which everyone knows about in Melbourne anyway, so come and get me. How's that for beauty? How's that for security? Just don't get it. Work to rule, I deliver the mail. Now apply this to your business. How many people do things that just work to rule? No, I just deliver the mail. Never mind that there's lots of stuff there like credit cards and private information. No, I'm just the postman. I'm just the forklift driver. And who's going to clean this? No wonder we have floods. And then when we have floods, I'll say, oh, you know, the rain, the flooding. No, because the jolly thing is, who out of 10,000 people who work at council are going to say, I work at council, I'm responsible? No, I'm not responsible. We have to open up people's eyes. Oh, yeah. Measure it and they'll do it. Yeah. Deliver the papers, and if you deliver the paper, you get the money. So the guy keeps delivering the paper, and I'm thinking, when's he going to stop? No one's home. But I get measured on delivering the paper, so I'm delivering the paper. You've got to know the rules, and we don't know the rules, so please send your people cross-pollinate them, send them from here to there, send them to meet the customer, get them to talk to experts. You cannot sit in the office and say you understand about the risks to your business. You've got to get people out and feeling and touching and teach people how to cook the books and teach them how to hack into systems so that they can see it when it's happening in front of them. This is the gents on level one of the Regent Hotel in Sydney in George Street, which is now called the Four Seasons. And that's fine. You walk in, that's fine. Look at the lock. Look at the lock. That's fine. You can lock it. But on the inside, you cannot have that. That is a risk because if someone locks it and they don't know you're still in there, and there's a fire, you're stuck in. You cannot have an egress in this fashion. They just don't know. How can they not know? They own the biggest hotels and properties in the world. They don't know the rules. No. And when you don't know the rules, you will fail. And how are you going to know the rules? Because she goes, he comes, she goes, and I'm at this and I. You've got to get people engaged, and everybody's got to know the rules. You can't say, oh, I'm just. You don't understand. People don't understand. Look how many people prop the door open. When it says, fire door, do not obstruct, they don't understand. So here's the thing. People have to believe, understand, accept and adopt consistently. If they don't believe what you're saying, understand it, accept and adopt it, they will not do it consistently. We have told a million people a million times, don't smoke, you will die, they still smoke. Don't drink and drive, they still drink and drive. Don't speed in wet road, they still speed. Shut the door, do not, this is a fire door, they still open it. Why? Because they don't understand, don't listen. The way I demonstrate, every shop I walk into now, they have cameras. But they don't have a clue because here's the controller and it's on the top shelf. You just press stop and go do all your thieving. the number of photos I have, I've got thousands of photos like this. This isn't an isolated case. You look, next time you go into a shop, just see where's the controller. Absolutely unbelievable. We give too much away. We tell them at the airport what could be a good thing to use to gain the upper hand. We say, during the demonstrations, the police had the police horse riding, what are they called, mounting?